film, the lubricant thickness will become minimum. It is called as thin film bearing, also called as boundary lubricated bearing. Zero film bearing means there is no lubricant. Okay, the zero film bearings are those which operate without lubricant present. Called as self lubricated bearings. So it is based on the material which you use to manufacture the bearing. So thick film, enough lubricant film will be there. Thin film, because of operating conditions, etc., the film will become very thin. It is called as boundary lubrication. So in boundary lubrication regime, chances of wear will be high. When the third one is zero film bearing, that self lubricated bearing. There is no lubricant, that self lubricated bearing. Hydrostatic or externally pressurized lubricated bearing. Here a high pressure pump is used to supply the oil into journal and bearing gas. It is called as hydrostatic or externally pressurized bearing. So these are the classification according to thickness of layer of lubricant between bearing and journal. Then we shall move to the various materials used for bearing and rolling contact bearing. Again, it also depends on the application, light load application, heavy load application, or high speed, low speed, okay, and the environment. So based on these factors, you can select the materials used for bearing contact bearing. So first one is Babbitt metal, then bronze metal. So bronze metal is especially suitable for high speed application. Then phosphor bronze, again this is also suitable for high pressure and high speed. Cast iron, cast iron is also used. So such type of bearings are fairly successful where lubrication is adequate and pressure is limited pressure, and speed is 40 meters per minute. Then silver is particularly used in aircraft engine bearing. Okay. Then non-metallic bearings like rubber, wood, plastic, etc. are also used for some special applications. Okay. So these are the various materials used to classify. Various materials used to fabricate bearings. Then now the question is how it works. So there will be working principle of hydrodynamic bearing. You can see the three diagrams in the figure. First one is at rest. Second one is starting and running. So what happens at rest? So because of load, okay, self load and self weight, the bearing is in suspension. That is at center go. Okay, so it is at rest. As journal starts to rotate, it will climb the bearing surface. Why journal will start to rotate? When you switch on the machine, the shaft starts to rotate. Please remember, there will be a lubricant between journal and bearing. When you switch on the machine, the shaft starts to rotate. The shaft in the sense journal. Okay? So journal starts to rotate until it will climb the bearing surface. Look into the figure B. It is climbing the bearing surface. So when speed is increasing further, it forces the fluid into wedge-shaped region between journal and bearing. As I said, already fluid is there here, okay, lubricant is there. So when it starts to rotate, when it reaches to stable speed, then the journal forces the fluid into wedge-shaped region. The fluid will be forced into wedge-shaped region between journal and bearing. Okay. So figure A, it is at initial position at rest. When you switch on the machine, it starts to climb, then there will be wedging action will be there. Next. So further, as more and more fluid is forced into wedge shaped region, this is called as wedge shaped region. Okay. When more and more fluid is forced into wedge-shaped region, the pressure is generated within the fluid as shown in figure. The pressure will be generated. So this is your pressure. Okay, pressure is generated as shown in figure. The this fluid pressure is generating clear, I mean clearance space supports the external load. So this pressure is going to support the load. What is load? I have shown some applications. So these are loads. Okay, power generation. Okay, so the heavy load will be there. And in the case of IC engine, okay, load will be there. While transmitting the reciprocating motion into rotary motion, load will be acting. So here, yeah, the fluid pressure generated in the clearance supports the external load. Sangharatna, are you there?
Yes sir.
Pressure will be created in the in this clearance because of rotation which carries the load. The fluid pressure generated in the clear, then the clearance space supports the external load. External load is particular application which you have selected. Then the hydrodynamic lubrication does not need supply of lubricant at high pressure from external source pump. Okay. So this is hydrodynamic bearing, and there is no requirement of external supply of lubricant because the lubricant between journal and bearing is enough to rotating action create itself for the pressure to carry the load. So that is the concept. This is the pressure distribution in journal bearing. Okay. At rest, starting and running. So during running condition, there will be because of wedging action of lubricant, it carries the load. Okay. So this is the working principle of hydrodynamic journal bearing. So as I said, this is journal bearing. And journal and bearing, in between journal and bearing, clearance will be there. It is called as clearance. Okay. So this is the lubricant is also shown here. And you can see the film thickness. Film thickness, lubricant between journal and bearing at this position. Okay. So this is called as maximum film thickness. And clearance is very minimum here. It is called as minimum film thickness. All these parameters are used to design the journal bearing. Okay. So this is your pressure distribution. Okay. So because of when high speed when the journal starts rotating at high speed, it creates a pressure is created in the clearance which supports the load. Okay. So that is the concept of this journal bearing. So you can note down these terms, I mean nomenclature used in the journal bearing. Diameter clearance, which is the difference between diameter of bearing and journal. Mathematically C is equal to D minus T. So this is D, okay, D minus D. Okay, this is clearance. This is the clearance C. You can look at the diagram. Okay. So, difference between diameter of bearing and journal. Diameter of the journal and bearing. We will get clearance. Then, radial clearance. So, radial clearance is the difference between radii of the bearing and journal. Mathematically, it is given by this equation. Capital R minus small r. This is your C by 2, radius, diametral clearance and radial clearance. Then diametral clearance ratio. It is the ratio of diametral clearance to diameter of the journal. Mathematically, it is given by this equation C by B. Okay. So, diameter clearance, radial clearance, and diameter clearance ratio. Next, eccentricity. Eccentricity is the radial distance between O of the bearing and displacement at O dash. See here. O and O dash. Okay. Right? O and O dash. Next. So, minimum field thickness. I already showed here. So, this is minimum field thickness and maximum field. H max is minimum. So, here minimum field thickness is the minimum distance between journal and bearing under complete lubrication condition. It is denoted by H naught, which occurs on the line of center as shown in diagram. So, this is line of center. This is your minimum field thickness. Then, attitude or eccentricity ratio. It is the ratio of eccentricity to radial clearance. It is given by this equation. Epsilon is equal to small e by C1 or 1 minus 2H0 by C. And short and long bearing. Short and long bearing. So, if the ratio of length to diameter is less than 1. So, this is your length. Okay, length and diameter. Length and diameter, if it is less than 1, then the bearing is said to be short bearing. On the other hand, if LBD ratio is greater than 1, then it is long bearing. So, short bearing and diameter. Less than 1 is short bearing, more than 1 it is called as long bearing. Okay. These are some important terms. Then, bearing characteristic number. This number is very important in design of bearing. Okay, if you want to know the operating condition, operating condition is appropriate or not, you are supposed to use this bearing characteristic number. It means it is important to design journal bearing. So it is given by this equation mu is equal to pi Zn by T D by C L by T. Okay. So why it is required, I can show you. So this is for your stitching plug. So here there is I request our students to mute students.
Students, please mute your voice. Actually, please mute your voice. It's getting disturbance, okay? Please mute. Pritam, yes, sir, please proceed, sir. As you got in, sir.
Fine.
Yes, sir.
Now, using this curve, you will be able to know whether journal bearing is lubrication or not. Okay? You can see three lubrication regimes here. Okay, so this is called as thick film lubrication, partial lubrication, and thin film lubrication. Right? So to know about this, you are supposed to calculate Zn by T. That is viscosity, speed, and load. So based on this, you will be able to judge whether your bearing is operating in good condition or not. That is the beauty of this equation. So, for this, you are supposed to find out the bearing characteristic number. It is Zn by T. So, here, mu is friction coefficient. You can find the friction coefficient. Okay? So, it is like this. As you increase the speed, at the initial stage, the friction coefficient is high. So, as you increase the speed, it will come down. Okay? Then it is further it increases. That is the concept. So in this, so here we have three lubrication regimes: thick, partial, and thin, which is found using this equation. So mu is friction coefficient, phi is the partial relationship, that is absolute viscosity, n is speed, p is bearing pressure, okay, and p is determined by using the equation, this equation, then d is diameter of journal, l is length of bearing, and c is diameter of clearance. So the definitions are already given. Diameter of clearance is the difference between diameter of bearing and journal. It is given by d minus d. So with this, you will be able to design a bearing. Yeah. So this is called as cubic curve. Okay. So normally, it is appropriate to operate the journal bearing in thick-film lubrication. Some cases, it goes to the partial lubrication regime. But boundary lubrication regime is not advisable. Okay. Because severe wear will be there. How do you say it is severe wear? Because friction wearness will be high. So it will keep on increasing here. So that's why it is not advisable to operate the journal bearing in thin boundary lubrication regime. It's unstable. Okay, the sure heat, it is unstable. So thick film lubrication is always advisable. So you are supposed to design a bearing such a way that it should operate either in thick film or partial lubrication regime. Why? You are supposed to minimize wear and friction during operating conditions. So that's here, that is possible by using this equation, bearing characteristic number. Then you can find out friction coefficient using this equation. Of course, Petrov equation is also there. So this one is more popular. A key equation is a popular equation to find out the friction coefficient in journal bearing. Here K is factor for correction for leakage depends on the ratio of length to diameter. As I said, short bearing or long bearing is there. No? So this is 0.002 for L by D ratio, 0.25 to 0.75 to 2.3. So K is correction factor. Then Somerfield number. So this is important number used in design of bearing. The Somerfield number is also dimensionless parameter used extensively to design journal bearings. It is given by this equation. Z n by C is equal to 3 by C whole square. Okay. So then the purpose of the bearing is to minimize friction and wear. How it is possible? It has to carry over the heat generated in the journal bearing. It is given by this equation. Qg, heat generated is given by Qg is equal to mu Wv. Okay. So at the same time, we can also find out heat dissipated. Heat generated, heat dissipated. Both are important. How much heat is generated during a particular application and how much heat is dissipated. Okay. Both should match. Some correlation should be there. Okay. Heat generated is more. Heat dissipated is less, it won't work. Okay? It has to dissipate maximum heat generated during a particular application. Heat generated and heat dissipated. So you can find both. Yeah. So these are the unit conversion. So yeah. Design steps. So there are some steps to design the journal bearing. Okay, you can go through this. And now you are open for discussion. If you have any questions, you can ask. Then after this, we will solve a simple problem to understand the concept of journal bearing. You have any questions?
Dear students, if you have any questions, please type in the chat box so that Sarishwar can answer those questions. Okay, we cannot unmute all the students, so please type in the chat box. Whatever you have studied, if you have any doubt, please raise your voice. Please, 5 minutes.
I will look at chat box and explain.
Yes, sir. Just a minute, sir. Actually, chat box Yes, managed panels, so many body instructions. Yes, now I have added a chat box here. Sorry for this. Now you please ask whatever the doubts you are having in this session. So sir will answer this. Quickly you please ask this, okay? Yes. So sir, you can mute us all as well. Yes, please ask the question. Abhishek, do you have any question? If there are doubts will be there, you can clarify those doubts just now, okay? So quickly, you can have about 2 to 3 minutes to ask your doubts. You can type in the chat box so that question I can share with the sir. Because this is our second unit that we are going to study. Okay, so definitely this topic I will not going to cover now. So if you are having any doubt, please let me know. Yes, Ankit, do you have any doubt? Ankit?
Yes, sir.
Do you have any doubt? Please ask some questions if you have any doubt.
No, sir. There is no doubt.
Okay. Chaitanya?
Okay.
So, okay, if you don't have any doubt, we'll proceed and then we'll end up the session. Okay. So, sir, please continue.
Okay. Yeah. So, let us come for a simple problem. I suggest students to take up this problem. Okay. General bearing of 100 mm diameter and 150 mm long carries a radial load of 7 kN at 1200 rpm. So the radial clearance is 0.05 mm. Find the viscosity of oil being used in operating temperature if 1.2 kilo power is measured in friction. To find out the viscosity.
Write down this numerical. You have to submit this information to me. Okay?
No, they can solve now.
Yes.
Data is given. Okay?
Please try to solve it and tell me the formula is with you.
Everything is there. It's clear. Okay?
The data is with you. You can tell the value of mu.
Yeah. You are supposed to find out that M is there, T is there. So this is the equation. Note on this equation first. Yeah. So the heat generated is given by mu F B. Okay. So with this data you can proceed. So find out the B first. By D and by 60. Okay. Then you substitute the values. You will get mu friction coefficient. So F is there, F is given, 7000 newtons. What is the value of B?
Calculate the value of B. Please calculate, everything is with you, all the given data is with you, the formula is with you, and you tell the value, what are the value you are getting? Aditya is calculated 6283.18, is it correct sir?
Let's check. 6 meters per second.
Six meters per second. Yeah. Mm per second. Right. Yeah.
And you know, the mu is given by this equation. You find out mu.
The Maxwell's equation is given. You please try to calculate the value of mu. Yes, Abhishek is 6.18, so somewhat nearer, but the value is 6.3 meters per second. Okay, so there might be some digital errors are there. Okay, so this is considered. We will try to calculate the value of coefficient of friction mu.
You have D Hg is 1200 watt. So you can calculate mu.
From this engineering equation.
We have F and V. Calculate mu.
This is Abhishek. Please try to calculate. Anyone can calculate the value of mu? See, Hg is given, mu you have to calculate, F value is given, and V now just now you have calculated. Put the value and calculate the value of mu. Abhishek? 0.27, sir, 0.15, 0.27, what is the value?
Check.
0.27.
0.027.
Somebody got this value.
Okay. Now you are supposed to find out viscosity, that is Z, from this equation. Okay? So here we have everything except P. Bearing pressure except bearing pressure, we have everything.
Yes.
So you calculate bearing pressure. So pressure is given by force by area, isn't it? So F by D L. D is there, L is there.
First calculate the value of bearing pressure.
You calculate P first, then you will get value of Z, that is viscosity.
So D and L, sir, what is the value of D and L?
D and L, data.
Yes, sir.
D is 150 mm, D is 100 mm.
LPG ratio. Please note down this value. 0.46 bearing pressure meter per
m. Yes, 5.47
newton
per meter square.
What are you?
Coming to K. Okay. So this K, so we have to raise down the LPG ratio and select K, value of K. Yeah, here. K is factor to correct for end leakage. It depends on the ratio L by D. So it is 0.002 for L by D ratio, 0.752, 2.8. So if your L by D ratio is 0.75 to 2.8, then you can take it as 0.002. Now, so what is your L by D ratio here? What is L by D ratio?
Divide 150 by 100.
It is around
1.5.
So you can select K as 0.002. Okay? So for that way, you can select this value. Now you can find out the value of that.
Calculate the value of J, you got everything.
Viscosity you are supposed to find out.
Students, please calculate and tell me yes, Aditya, what value of yes you got? See, every data is with you. C is with you, D and C value. Okay. जीरो पॉइंट जीरो टू टू था सर ऑडियो अभी चेक करिए
विस्कोसिटी इज 0.0224 केजी मीटर सेकेंड केजी पर मीटर सेकेंड सो दिस इज हाउ यू आर सपोज टू डिजाइन एंड जनरल बेयरिंग यूर फॉर पर्टिकुलर एप्लीकेशन ओके सो दिस पर्टिकुलर एप्लीकेशन इज इट कैरी 7 किलो न्यूटन लोड at 1200 RPM in some application. Okay, I think some just will So, this is about introduction to journal diary. Of course, you can proceed with your, you know, other by solving other parameters, etc. For other parameters and so for application, etc. Yeah, any questions you can ask?
You have, if you have any questions, please raise your voice. Okay, type in the chat box so that I can convey the same. Sir, can we get this presentation? Yes, sir, can we get this presentation? Students are asking.
Sure. Yes. I'm sending it.
Yes. Sir will send to me, I will share with you guys. Okay? And if any, other doubt, please let me know.
Any doubt from your end, Sangharatma? You have any doubts in this?
No, sir, actually, it's a very good presentation. That's why I have attended, sir. Once again, I am recording all the things. Students, if they have any doubt? Thanks for the wonderful session, sir. Alisa, we got to say thanks for the wonderful session.
Mm-hmm.
The feedback from the students, sir.
Okay.
Good. So, if you do not have any doubts, so I will conclude here. Sir, we conclude here.
Okay.
Sir, just a minute, sir. You can stop sharing your slide. Sir, I would like to present a vote of thanks and for today's guest lecture and for enlightening us with your knowledge, sir. Today's lecture was very impressive and full of knowledge and interesting topic, sir. It gave us deep insight into the topic and also revealed some interesting facts, sir. The points where you told us about the journal bearing, sliding bearing, classification of sliding bearing and design of journal bearing was really interesting. And I am pretty sure that the picture quality you have given will definitely help us in our studies and our future studies in their future also. Thank you so much, sir, for giving your precious time from your busy schedule. Thank you so much, sir.
You're welcome. Thank you.
Thank you, students, for attending. So, we are now ending the session and the PPT will be sent, I will send the PPT to me and I will share it with you.
Okay.
Thank you so much, sir. Thank you so much, sir.
Welcome.
Sir, you can stop sharing your place.
Yeah. I did it.
Yes, sir. Thank you for your presence. Okay. So 1:45 we are having another class. So thank you so much. You can leave now.